This MLK Day, the Central Kitsap High School ASB would like to celebrate and remember the lasting legacy of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. As an ASB, we recognize that our assemblies in previous years have focused solely on the past as opposed to addressing the ever-present racial injustices that occur in everyday America.
We want to go further than to simply reflect on the work of Martin Luther King Jr. as a thing of the past, and actively address the racial injustices in our school and in our community. While we are still learning our role in this, we welcome any input on how we should proceed with respect to our communities of color.
With the terrible murders of Breonna Taylor, Tamir Rice, Casey Goodson, Trayvon Martin, Eric Gardner, Sandra Bland, Michael Brown, Ahmaud Arbery, George Floyd, and countless other black people who were victims of police brutality and racism, we condemn these murders and we stand with the black members of our school and community.
We as an ASB believe that black lives matter. Now more than ever, it is vital to support our students of color and continue educating our student population on the dangers of racism that are ever present in our school and community.
Our ASB strives to not only recognize and appreciate MLK's great accomplishments and legacy, but to apply them to the monumental events that are happening currently in the United States.
We acknowledge that the Black Lives Matter movement has existed long before its resurgence last year and is not a passing trend.
Our goal as an ASB is to give a voice to the unheard and to promote the change we need in our school and society to honor Dr. King's legacy.
Moving forward, we pledge to do everything in our power to amplify the unheard voices of our community to create meaningful and lasting change, striving towards racial equality in our homes, school, and community. It is our goal and our responsibility to foster growth, challenge our pre-existing biases, and to carry on the modern legacy of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr.
Last year was one filled with hatred, especially from all the black lives that were taken from police brutality. This is why I like to say I became an activist. I got so tired of seeing on the news and not doing anything with my voice that I started going and participating in protests, started posting on social media to educate others, which I know many of my classmates did. Now the situation here is why there needs to be a change. I got pulled over in October because my taillights were out. As I rolled down my tinted windows at night for a car full of black young women, I was frightened, not knowing who were the next victims. My body trembled and tears ran on my face. The police asked me why I was scared, as if forgotten how many black lives were taken from police brutality throughout the years. This is the reason why I'm fighting, because as a 17-year-old, I shouldn't be afraid. Afraid of the same thing that my parents, my grandparents, ancestors, etc. all went through. As Martin Luther King said, there will be neither rest nor tranquility in America until the Negro is granted his citizenship right. And that's how America is right now, not at rest nor tranquility. I will continue to fight for peace and equality because this is tiring and sad that racism has never ended. And it may never end, but one day I hope that others who have hatred will understand and come to realization that one of these things that comes from that hatred is fear. Because living in fear that I know many of my fellow black people do is not it. I know that for some, I may not change your mind just by a small speech, but I hope this pushes you further into the right direction to make a change in racism. Especially with police brutality, because a change starts with you. With saying all that, I'm very appreciative and thankful for being awarded the CK Nobel Peace Prize, which I will hold in great honor. Now I hope others will continue to fight for the equality of black lives.
On August 28, 1963, Martin Luther King gave his famous I Have a Dream speech in Washington, D.C. Much has changed since 1963, but it's still not enough. 2020 was hard on everyone, but no one has experienced as much hurt as the Black population. Breonna Taylor's life was taken in her own apartment. Ahmaud Arbery was going for a jog. Elijah McClain was walking from the store where he had just bought tea. Like MLK has said, injustice anywhere is a threat to justice everywhere. I personally believe there is no greater way to uphold MLK's legacy than to continue advocating for the change he wanted. However, I feel it is not my place to decide. During this time, it is everyone's job to not use their own voice, but to elevate the voices of Black people. Take the time out of your day to watch Black movie productions, read books by Black authors, and educate yourself the best you can on the history of Black people in the United States. In 2020, we lost Georgia Representative John Lewis, who was inspired by MLK's actions and fought alongside him for civil rights. It is important to remember those who advocated for change before us, just like we do on Martin Luther King Day. Each and every day, we can take actions towards MLK's goals by doing what is right and advocating for change in the communities around us.
Hi Cougars, this is Jennifer Rumpke, and today I'm going to talk to you about the modern legacy of the movement, youth activism. Did you know that Martin Luther King Jr. was just 26 years old when he became the face of the civil rights movement, leading the Montgomery bus boycott in 1955? The first woman to refuse to move to the back of the bus and challenge her arrest was 15-year-old Claudette Colvin. Ruby Bridges was only 6 years old when she integrated an all-white elementary school in New Orleans in 1960. In the spring of 1963 in Birmingham, Alabama, over 4,000 school children organized a walkout, starting a week of mass demonstrations. The Little Rock Nine were high school students just like you. The Greensboro Four, who started using sit-ins to protest segregation, were all college students. Youth were at the heart of the civil rights movement throughout the 1960s and inspired generations of young people to organize against oppression and injustice. Young people were the core of the anti-war movement in the 1970s. It was students who led the protest against a repressive Chinese government in Tiananmen Square in 1989. It was youth who utilized social media to organize protests and raise global awareness of oppressive regimes across the Arab world a decade ago. In 2016, in an effort to preserve sacred native lands, it was young people who organized at Standing Rock to protest the Dakota Access Pipeline. In 2018, high school students organized and led nationwide protests against gun violence and school shootings. And just this past summer, it was local young people, including many CK students, who turned their outrage over the murder of George Floyd into protests and marches for Black lives. In fact, the CK Social Studies Department was so impressed and so inspired by these students and their organization, Kitsap Youth Action Team, that we have created a new one-semester course devoted to social justice movements in America. Next year, students in this course will explore how Americans have worked collectively to create change and challenge injustice. You will not learn just the history of organizations like the Black Panthers or ACT UP, but what strategies are effective when advocating for social justice. You are never too old or too young to be a powerful agent of change. All of us have the power and the choice to make this world a better place. This is the legacy of Martin Luther King Jr., and hopefully, an inspiration to us all.
We've got some difficult days ahead, but it really doesn't matter with me now, because I've been to the mountaintop. I don't mind. Like anybody, I would like to live a long life. Longevity has its place, but I'm not concerned about that now. I just want to do God's will. And he's allowed me to go up to the mountain. And I've looked over. And I've seen the promised land. I may not get there with you. But I want you to know tonight that we as a people will get to the promised land.